Hello everybody and welcome to the Rosenheim City Grid. This is your man Shorty again. We're here with the second round of the Rosenheim City Grid lockdown event. This time we are featuring two players from Munich. On the left we have DL7RRK, which I will call, for reasons I will just call him DL. And on the right hand side we have Armin Firecracker. So both players are from Munich, they know each other. Munich is like the neighboring meta from Rosenheim, so we always have a lot of exchange in players if there are tournaments at Rosenheim or if there are tournaments in Munich, which is quite cool. On the left, DL is playing, I think this should be Maximum Punk Rock Anarch ID, which is sitting on 6 ID points. I think this is a proxy because nobody had the max identity. And Armin Firecracker on the right is playing Tainin Institute, which is a Gentechia identity that is sitting on 3 identity points. So max is at the beginning of your turn you're gonna discard the top 2 cards of your stack and the third card you put into your hand. And Tainin will let you put an advancement token on any card if the runner don't make a successful run on his or her last turn. So the game is already starting. We have 2 keeps, I think. And Tainin is starting already very aggressive with an ice in a new remote, a card in a new remote, and a hedgefall. So we're gonna discard a Sure Gamble. The first card I missed, okay, was a Devil's Charm. Yes, please put it near the camera. Devil's Charm into Sure Gamble was discarded and an unknown card was drawn here. So what do you do as Max here? Do you check some centrals? Okay, another Sure Gamble. That's good, already getting up some money here for thrashing assets. Or okay, very clear. We can see the credits this time with the official FFG Netrunner tokens. That is good because I know these. I think you want to run some central here. Oh, this is a God of War, I think. There's an AI breaker that can give you techs, and for the amount of techs you gain, virus counters you can use to break ice. So it seems like this is a tech near max, which is interesting. Running R&D here, checking the top card. Oh, it's a Future Perfect, so we're gonna start with a Psy game right here. That is good. If DL is able to steal this one, this would be very good to start off with a 3-point agenda. Otherwise, you can run R&D again, or you just let it go into HQ next turn with the mandatory draw. At least you know where it's been found. Both paying 0, so DL is taking the 3 points here. That is cool. I think Armin is not too stoked about this. Checking R&D again, this time seeing Anansi from the top of R&D. This one will very surely go onto R&D or HQ next turn. I'm guessing the unadvanced card here is a Rashida. Yes, it's a Rashida. That's the perfect turn 1 install. Drawing 3 cards here, getting 3 credits. That's a lot of tempo. That's a lot of tempo. Tainin didn't trigger here because they were a successful run. Seen any card here. I'm just guessing the Tainin will close off all centrals just to get some value out of the identity very early. You have the money for the Anansi. I think that was the mandatory draw. I'm really thinking here. I can't see the cards in the hand. I'm sorry. Don't know what options are open here. Yeah, that early steal from the Future Perfect, that was bad. That was bad, I think, but Armin did the right thing, just spending 0 for the Psy game. Otherwise, you might end up doing a lot of Psy games when the runners run again on R&D or HQ, and in the end he might even steal it no matter what, so just let it go. That's fine, that's fine. Okay, so we're gonna see a card installed into the remote and two eyes on the centrals. One of these is supposedly the Anansi, which you don't want to face tank into. So the God of War is starting to give max tags here for the exchange of two virus counters. And we're gonna treasure the tag me trading from criminals. Well, at least it's a lot of money. And the second card I think is on alt art from, is it zero? And we're gonna draw into a Simul chip. I hope I'm not missing anything here. This is very hard to see the card so soon, so quickly. Oh, this is an Akashia. That's a quite cool card. So if Armin is purging, DL can trash the Akashia. Can trash the Akashia, and for each virus counter that was purged, you gain one credit. Which is a fun card. That is an absolutely fun card. So this is telegraphing a lot more viruses. Maybe it's just as a backup for the God of War. It's an interesting matchup because Tenin might not have any tech punishment here, so Max can go tech me as she wants to. I think turn that was a draw into a Stim Hack. I think that was the core set Stim Hack. Very ugly artwork, but I love it. It's so pulpy and so cool. Another draw here. Didn't realize what the card was. Okay, installing the Simul chip. Yeah, don't know what you want to bring back. Maybe it's just a good include for Max if all your valuable breakers are getting into the bin by your identity draw. And we have an advancement from Tenin because there were no successful run this turn, and a triple advance into a Nisei Mark II. That is cool. That is cool. Okay, so the best Shinteki agenda is already scored here. So the agenda suit might look like 3 Nisei, 3 Ubokata. Oh no, Ubokata was banned. Ubokata was banned. Seeing a paperclip here, hitting the bin from Max. That is something you want to see. I think this is a 45 card Max. It doesn't seem like it's a big stack Max with 100 cards or even more. And just gaining some money here. Not using the God of War this turn, which is interesting. Okay, there is the last sure gamble. That was where 3 very fast sure gambles. Really curious what the recursion here is on the runner side, or if there is any recursion, because once you are drawn out of cards, it's a bit bad to play against Shinteki with all those net damage cards and net damage ice. Okay, seeing a second Simul chip here. Just doing a little bit of setup. There is not too much to do here, nothing to contest. You don't want to face tank into the ice if you don't have enough credits. And yeah, well, so an advancement token is going on the remote ice for free, installing something into the remote, icing up the remote and icing up archives. Okay, so this is what you want to see as Tenin, having ice everywhere, having a little bit of money, not too much here. Drawing another God of War and if it worse. One card goes to hand. This time using the... Okay, oh, so DL is using dices. That makes it a little bit difficult. I think there's... No, 3 tokens? I'm not sure. I am sorry. This is very hard to see. But I think that's 3 virus tokens and 3 tags. There's another Devil's Charm, which is very good for the God of War. So you don't need to pump up the strength. For example, if you hit an Anansi. the card into server 1 could be pretty much everything. Could be a defensive upgrade. Could be another Rashida. Okay, going for a Stim Hack here. Oh no, that is the revised core set Stim Hack. Seeing an Arcade on the remote, that is a barrier. No advancements here yet, so it's only a 2-strength, 2-sub barrier, which can be break very easy. The God of War, at least it taxes you out some of the virus tokens. Nice include for Tenin. I think it's not too much influence, might be 2 influence. Right now he is able to break both subs. And I think you want to break both subs, so paying 2 for the strength. Breaking 2 subs here. Only a single virus counter is left. Still plenty of money, and this is a mind game. Okay, this is 0 to rest to make up Psygame to redirect. I think you want to break this. You still have 6 credits left for the Stim Hack, or 7 credits even. Yeah, pump up the strength. Taking 1 from the personal credit stash here. I think it's 2 to boost 1 strength, so this is 8 credits to boost up the strength, 1 virus token to break the subroutine, and it's a Rashida. And Rashida getting trashed, that's a good trash. I think with the Stim Hack you can live with that. Now you know what you need for the remote. Once the Arcade has 3 advancement tokens, this is gonna be a little bit more taxing here. Doing 1 brain damage. trying to randomize it. What is this? I think this is counter surveillance. The one where you can multi-access on R&D for the amount of tax you have. That is cool, yeah. That is a win condition. That is one of the win conditions. So that the Rashida is gone is good. I think you might be tempted. Yeah, no, you don't want to face tank into anything here. Drawing even more, and yeah, passing the turn. Mandatory draw. Yeah. I mean, it's quite low on credits here. 5 credits is not a lot to operate with. We still have the Nisei token and another install and advance on server 1. I think DL is able to contest the remote if he takes another tag. The God of War, thrashing a chisel here. Oh, what is this? I don't know what that card is. All those alt arts, I don't know all those alt arts that are available. There are so many. You might know it if you know what cards I am missing here. Just write it in the comments. I am absolutely fine with that. Please just write everything in the comments. Any feedback, I don't care. If you hate me, just write it in the comments. I'm fine with that. I can live with any feedback. This might be another Nisei. Well, you... Maybe Armin is gambling here. As an emergency, you can always use the Nisei token to end the run here. You really are forced to run that server here. This could also just be an NGO. You don't want to let another Nisei go that easy. Armin is only on 5 credits. This might be just an NGO here. This would be another Nisei. You are in a very bad spot already. If he's able to score this one without using the ability from the first Nisei that was scored. So 2 Nisei tokens. Oh, that is... So even a cheap remote or a semi-cheap remote is becoming hell of a card. Or hell of a difficult to run it. Simul chips don't help here too much. You have the paperclip, but you don't have the money for the paperclip for the install to breaking the Arcade. All three sure gambles are already gone, so I think there is no more options available to splash drawing up here. Maybe with another stim hack. But do you want to waste a stim hack here? Yeah, very difficult. You might want to poke centrals. You might want to poke centrals here just to force some reses. Okay, there is another copy of this card. I don't know what it is. Okay, it has eyes on it. I don't know. Is it maybe MK Ultra? Oh, I don't know. Okay, and running the remote. That's cool. With only a single credit left. Simul chip. Thrashing whatever this is. Bringing back the paperclip, I suppose. Oh, bringing back a chisel? Huh? Clip you can boost one. Now bringing the chisel on here, so you don't want to deal with the Akkad anymore. Right now it's a mild Akkad, it's not too bad yet. What is happening? I think you can Devil Charm it to instant kill it. Is it working like this? Letting the and the run and the Sapphire, running the server again. Letting the end the run and gain one place an advancement token Sapphire. And run it again, I suppose, and now kill this one. You can break through the mind game if you want to. No, it's checking out like it seems. You could use the Devil's Charm and the God of War to go through the server. No, he is letting the subs fire. Okay, we have a Psy game for a redirect. Both paying zero. Oh no. Oh no, that is not not the best day for Psy games here. But it's just an NGO. That is just an NGO. That is beautiful. This was costing here a lot of resources, a lot of credits, a lot of tempo to get into the remote here. The Akkad is gone. That's not too bad. And now you're sitting on 14, 15 credits. That is enough for the Anansi. Maybe the next ice that is going onto the remote is a little bit bigger. Might be a DNA tracker, Anansi. Max very low on credits here. Only a single credit left. Only a single credit left going into an IPO. What was it? Install. Draw install IPO. Rushing a chisel from the top and another one of those trading cards, I don't know, something with brokers and on the Wall Street. Oh, this card would be beautiful here. Ah, oh, this would be beautiful. This would gaining a lot of credits here. Oh, I'm thinking that DL is very sad to see both cards gaining into the bin here by Max. Cards in hand might be expensive. Okay, clicking for a credit. Clicking for another credit. Somebody that is really using the tokens that were provided from FFG. I never use them. I think they are looking cool, but they are clumsy. Okay, both paying one here. This was a run on the remote. Both paying one. Another losing Psy game for the Corp. It's a Rashida. Trashing the Rashida. That was a perfect trash. Oh, man. Oh, man. I think both are very sad here. Two sad players. They don't want to give the opponent anything here. Going. Last click for the last Simul chip. Simul chip can bring back the chisels here. Next turn you might want to go for some chiseling around if you have another program to install here. You might want to forfeit for the chisel. And I mean just keep on slamming cards into the remote here, keeping up the pressure. Gatewashing, ja, Rogniev Mercs. Cool card for a tag me. And trashing another paperclip. That's not too bad. You're not scared of meat damage here. And the bin breakers are always great in the bin. That's the place where you want them to see. So zero credits here. Already on six tags. So the virus tokens on the God of War are stacking up. You really need some money. You really need money here. A lot of cards are trashed already. I'm supposing we are half through the deck. Clicking for two credits. Keep on thinking here. Yeah, Armin is just too rich. Armin is just too rich. For two more credits. Yeah, that's that is a slow turn, but sometimes you are forced to do things like this, just clicking up for the credits. With Max is a little bit it's like you need to be lucky with RNG to drawing the right cards at the right moment. Okay, we have an undo click action here, and instead of clicking for a credit, installing another Akashia, gaining even more credit. So if there is a CVS in the deck, you might want to purge as the runner just to gain some credits, and popping the Akashias just to bounce back some money. We have a draw here. I think the top card is a Mescom. Yeah, good include. Very good include here for Tenin. Right now it's only worth 4 credits, which is that is a hedge for you can play for 0 credits. But money is not the problem here at the moment for the corp. The corp might just want to have some more eyes on the remote, and yeah. So the install card in server 1 was supposedly an upgrade. Installing another card into the remote and going for a hedge fall. So like I said, money is absolutely not the problem here. Could be an agenda, a never advanced agenda, could be another upgrade, maybe two upgrades. Stacking in the server here, waiting. Oh no, and the last one is gone. Okay, and the Devil's Charm is gone. Oh, that was a little bit unlucky. If he would have drawn these trading cards instead of getting trashed by Max, I think he would be on like 30 credits right now. No way to bring them back, I suppose. There are ways for runners to bring them back, but they are very, very expensive or very clumsy, very slow, or you need to pay a lot of influence for that. For credit. Okay, running the remote here. 3 credits. They're going for another Psy game, so DR is hoping for luck to be continued on the Psy game, and I think Armin is so hot right now and saying, no, this time I'm not losing the Psy game. Both paying 1, no! what are the odds? What are the odds? This is an unadvanced NGO. Still want to trash it, of course. You don't know what the other card is, but if the other card is a Bio Vault, that's 2 to trash. That would be very, very sad here. Or it's a Lacosta Grid. That is 4 to trash. You don't have the money anyways. Now you know what you're dealing with. Yeah, Lacosta is just so good. Just so good. And I think Armin is reading up a Bio Vault here. So Lacosta, you just need an agenda now to slam. And another ice. And there is a counter surveillance. Was this a draw, or did he drop it? What did happen? Why did he reveal the card? He wanted to install it and deciding to not do, but yes, installing it. Yeah, well, Armin already saw one of those. The problem with counter surveillance is you need to pay as much money, as much tax you have to access that many cards. So you need to have a lot of credits in the mid to late game to access that many cards. Armin need to read it up. Yeah, it's very strong. It's very strong in Techni decks. Issue here is that it's a resource and it can be easily trashed here by Armin. Armin has the money, Armin has the time. I think you want to trash it. You don't want to stick it on the board. Mandatory draw. DL is doing a good job here to make one a successful run each turn. To not let Armin have the free advancement tokens. Yes, Armin, I think you need to go as fast as possible here. As long as Max is on this low credit count, you really want to push. Might want to draw up for another card. Mescoms are clumping up the hand. You don't need the money right now. Maybe installing the buy vault. And go double advance, I don't know. I don't know what's a good play here. I can't see the whole hand. If he has an agenda, I would assume that he would instantly slam the agenda into the server, but no, he's installing a very needed second ice on the remote and of course thrashing the counter surveillance. This might be a slight misplay to install the counter surveillance. You might just want to install it the turn you want to pop it. Okay, this was really okay. There are two kinds of stim hacks. This was the old school stim hack. And thrashing another counter surveillance. I think all three counter surveillance are gone now. Stim hacks would be also very helpful for the remote. At one point of time, you want to get rid of the Lacosta grid that is installed here. Laborites shuffling back some cards, removing from the game, thrashing Peace in Our Time. Whatever that is, and another Peace in Our Time. I think the second one, was it a mimic? Was it the Nisei art from Worlds, from the first Worlds? There were very cool playmats. Oh, I can remember that artwork. If it is the mimic artwork. So many cool artworks. So what do you want to shuffle back? A counter surveillance, yeah, you want something to win. You want something to win here. Well, Laborites is one of the cheap ways to bring back some cards. And bringing back another counter surveillance, that sounds fair. And a Peace in Our Time, just to have some splash draw. You don't care about the Corp's money here anymore, Corp is so rich. Corp is so rich, you just need to find a way to catch up with the money race here. No runs on the centrals here, since they are iced on turn 3 or 4 or whatever this was. But a lot of pressure for the runner onto the remote, and the runner keeps up. He somehow, with that low credits, he still keeps up and checking the server whenever needed. Still a lot of bluff cards left. I think there's one Rashida left, one NGO left. We have three BioVault supposedly left. So a lot of things you can never advance or install advance into the server. Clicking for credits here. Yeah, you need the credits. You only need the credits. Well, the card could also be an imp on top here. Okay, face tanking into R&D, so the Anansi was going on to R&D. I think DL just want to check the waters for a later counter surveillance, what he needs to deal with. Yeah, you. Do you want to let this fire just for a single access? You can use the Devil's Charm here to lower the strength to 0 to break it for free with the God of War. Yes, that's a good decision. Breaking all the subs here. seeing a single card from R&D. I think this is an Embolus. Is it an Embolus? DL also need to read it up. Also, I hate Embolus. I hate those kind of card designs. It's like I was always confused at the beginning with Embolus and Biovolt. But while Biovolt is some kind of a semi-Nisei token, the Embolus stacking up if the runner don't make successful runs, which is also the plan for the Tenin, so that's a good include. That is a good include. I'm very happy I don't see it too often in normal play. I mean the Embolus, yeah, the Biovolt is everywhere, but Embolus is also a very good card. I'm happy not too many people play it. Armin is drawing up here, looking for an agenda, something to slam another ice and a card on server 1, so things are now get really, really spicy here for Max. Trashing a Obolus and another Yarokniev Mercs. Or Obelus, the Anna Council that was made for going tag me. That was the Omar Council, but I don't know why you want to go tag me with Omar. Makes absolutely no sense. I'm sorry, that was a motorcycle outside. This is a rough situation here. Max is losing more and more tempo while Armin just keep on going here. He might find another two-point agenda here. Not too many credits left if you want to score next turn together with the Lacosta grid. You could try and poke. Going for the mind game, just do the Psy game, let the subs fire. Yeah, a lot of thinking here. This is a puzzle you need to solve. For the moment, you're really struggling with money, and if you're struggling with money as a runner, that is always bad. That is always bad. You can't put up any pressure on the corp. You now lost the Devil's Charm. Well, Archives is not of interest at the moment. HQ also not might have too many agendas. I think DL is also realizing that every agenda that Armin will draw will straightly go into the remote. No contest here. Raising the Lacosta grid. Getting one token from Lacosta and getting a token from Tenin. Mandatory draw. Oh, this wasn't an agenda, it seems like. This might just be in the buy world, otherwise you really want to score it. Or Armin just don't want to go that low on credits. Now the mass comms would be cool here. Gaining 8 credits for a zero investment. Card is just so broken. Just a broken design. I hate those swingy cards. Hate cards that are so swingy. And cards that have like zero upfront cost. Okay, advancing that ice here to gain even more value from the mass comms. There is the mass comm, that's 10 credits. Five advanced cards, that's 5 times 2 credits, that's 10. Still have the Nisei token left here. One click left. and advancing. Advancing, they're supposedly BioVault again. Thrashing, I think that is imp. I think that is an imp. Thrashing an imp and a reshuffle. Peace in our time. Oh no. Oh no, this would be a good timing for peace in our time now after the mass com. Taking another tag here. Now we are sticking up 10 tags. Yeah, the Akashia. Right now it would be not too bad just to purge it away, but the God of War will stack up the virus token again. And you don't want the runner to give him money here. Especially if you see how often Max is forced to click for credits. Clicking for a credit here, clicking for another credit. Now sitting back on 7, that is like a new record since the last 10 turns with the amount of money stacking up to 7. And where one Mascom is, there are more Mascoms. There are for sure 3 Mascoms in the deck, and they will getting better and better each time. Now we have the counter surveillance. Installing it again, okay. Popping it. I think he needs to pay 10 credits for 10 tags here. I don't think you can do this. I think you need to pay 10. If I'm having the card right in mind, yeah. Yeah, DL is also realizing this. Undoing the click, just like in Jinteki.net. Not installing it, okay. That's a little bit sad because Army now know that there is one left. Yeah, you might want to stop taking tags and start clicking for credits until you're up on 10. And then seeing 10 cards here, this could be game winning. Seeing 10 cards from R&D. Whew. Haven't seen too many agenda points, only 5 agenda points out here. Clicking just for more money, yes. Next turn he might be able to go for the counter surveillance, discarding another God of War here. So Tenin getting a sweet free advancement token. Gaining advancement token on the Lacosta grid, yeah, now. That is a smart move, not putting on the BioVault. But putting on the Lacosta just to pump up the Mascoms, installing a card here and going for advance. And playing a Hyobu Precog Manifold. That is the Jinteki Lockdown. Which is basically a Nisei on a stick for the remote server now for this turn. Discarding the second level rights here. Not many cards left. Only 2 cards left. So next turn the max card draw won't happen anymore. Just 2 discards. So you need to handle with the cards you have in hand. I hope you have the last labor rights in hand. You can freely play it now. Or you can just go all in on R&D here. Like I said, the overcarters are banned. You don't need to be scared that you are not able to steal the overcarters out of R&D because you don't have enough cards in hand. That is something at least. Server 1 is total out of range with the precog manifold. I don't know if you can check that server 1. Interestingly, Armin did install advance and not did install only, so this is telegraphing this is a 3-point agenda. This might be another future perfect, which would be best case for Max here. Another Nisei would be worst case. Sorry for the short break, but family was arriving early, so I need to throw everybody out of the living room. I hope there's no more interruptions here. Okay, so we're gonna I missed that one. Don't know what's happening. You'd seen it, I hope. Maybe label writing here. No. Okay, so what do you do in this situation? Oh man. Oh man, oh man. You might just want to do the glory Hail Mary run on R&D here with the counter surveillance. Just clicking up for credits and then seeing 10 or maybe next turn 11 cards. Peace. So the remote is... You're locked out of the remote. No chance to contest the remote. As sad as it is to let this one go. I mean, also has the Nisei token here. Oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man. Clicking for 2 credits. Would be enough to install the counter surveillance and go for the counter surveillance here with 10 cards. This might win you the game. If not, you might lose the game here. Max is running out of cards. Yeah, Max was punished a lot by AR lab access, leaving the card pool. A lot of deck archetypes were hit by this. I'm taking for some more credits here and discarding. I think RD zero. I am not sure what alt arts DL is using here. Okay, putting an advancement token on the card that was installed last turn. Mandatory draw. Advance. Okay, this is a 3-point agenda. Oh, this is an SSL. Oh, yeah, this was banlist 2006, so SSL was still legal. Yeah, I mean, now on 5 points and the free advancement lets you install another card into the remote. So if this is another agenda, you have one turn left, so this is going down to the wire. Click one labor writing here. At least you can bring back 3 cards. The downside of discarding the top 3 cards is no more, because there are no cards left in the stack. Yeah, reshuffling the counter surveillances, why not, why not? He clicked a lot for credits, so I don't think he needs too many credits anymore. Okay, and sure gamble, just some splash money here. So you can't be sure you draw one of the counter surveillance. So if the order is very bad for you, you're gonna discard both counter surveillances. Okay, doing a draw. On second click, 2 clicks left, you could go for one of the counter surveillances and let the Anansi fire. Just want to click up for, if he is clicking up for more credits, he might be able to pump up the strength from God of War with this 10 credits to go up to 5 strength to break the Anansi, to not ditch so many cards, but you might don't have the time anymore. Next turn might be GG. You have a shot here, I think. You might want to go all in, installing the counter surveillance now and just go for it, letting the Anansi fire, seeing 10 cards and just hope for the best. Clicking for more credits here, going for a draw. Okay, it seems like he doesn't want to go for it now. He's gambling that this is not an agenda installed in the server, drawing up all the cards that were reshuffled. So there's at least 2 counter surveillance now here. Putting an advancement token with the Lacosta, putting one with the Tenin. Going triple install score. Oh no, that's GG. Oh, too bad. Too bad. I was really hoping we can see at least one of the counter surveillance runs. Yeah, you all those clicking for credits. Look at all those credits. Those were all credits gathered by click for credit. This was rough. This was rough. Yeah, but I mean, I felt like Armin had pretty much the upper hand from the beginning on. he was suffering a little bit by not finding an agenda, I suppose. But once the agenda are hitting the field and you have the Lacoste and you have a safe remote, there's not too much things that can go bad for you. Very, very well played, very well played. Also the L, well played. You tried your best. Okay, and now we are switching sides, and Armin is on Freedom Kumalo, which is only 7 ID points at the time that the lockdown was played. I think now it's a 10 or a 9 point identity, and that's for a good reason, because Freedom is very, very good. Interestingly, for Freedom on the ban list are quite some cards that are impactful for Freedom. So there is no Pelangi, no Kiko, no Consume, no Armakura, no SMC. Let's see what this Freedom is doing. And DL is interestingly on Jemison. Jemison Astronautic, so Wayland Identity, Fast Advanced Identity, or a Semi-Fast Advanced Identity. And that is sitting on only 4 ID points. So both players are using the full 10 identity points here, which is fair. You can always go for this and just hope you don't need your identity points for the... Oh, what is it called? Oh, my brain is so empty. My brain is so full of tiebreaker. I'm sorry. Gonna start to focus again here a little bit more. So now, second round, not too much time left here in the round. We have left 20 minutes. 20 minutes left, so this need to be a fast game. Inserting something into a remote. And double advance, and that is a hostile. Okay, getting the bad part, but also gaining the monies. Leaving up the centrals open against Freedom. Ooh, that is... This can be risky. Freedom strictly going into a career fair for the daily cast, providing you with a little bit of money. Okay, we have... Oh, that was too fast. That was too fast, okay. At least there were some neutral cards, some whaling cards and some other cards, I guess. I would run R&D here, or run HQ. Running R&D. This is... Oh my god, no. This is the government takeover. Steal from R&D on turn 1. No! Oh man, this is bad. NDL is out of his mind. He's like, what are the odds? What are the odds? Yeah, well, if you run government takeover, things like this could happen. Running R&D again, seeing a survivor from the top of R&D. So Armin is already on game point here. Oh, that is bad. This can be a very fast game. One agenda away from winning. Running HQ. Seeing, I think this was an archer, an alt art archer. Also have this one at home. Quite cool. Oh man, poor Jemison, poor Jemison. Already so much on the back foot. That's why I don't play government takeover, because this also happens to me a lot. A lot. And yeah. Icing R&D here, could be the Surveyor. Icing the remote, could also be the Surveyor. Telegraphing, there is no more agendas in hand here. Already 7 agenda points. And the first few cards, that's an IPO. Some more money's going on here. You have the Archer Father with the Hostile Takeover. You can always forfeit the Hostile Takeover for the Archer, which also plays into your identity as Jemison, because you can take 2 advancement token on a card. Okay, seeing trashing a hunting grounds here with the 0. Drawing 2 cards. Hunting grounds might not be useful here in the game at all, might be a dead card against Wayland. Running HQ here. And this one is the... What is this one? I can't remember. I know that card. I know that card. It's an asset. I will look it up and link it down in the description below. And installing another daily cast. So more drip econ is coming up here. Mandatory draw, install something into the remote. Install something into a new remote. And icing up HQ. Yeah, you need to be very cautious. Every access can be your end here. Every access could be game. Zeroing again, drawing a black orchestra. That's something you want to see. Go into the bin. Drawing two cards, gaining a credit. A lot of efficiency here together with two daily cards ticking down. You are not forced to do anything. You can just slowly set up your whole board. Gaining credits, gaining your breakers into the bin. Or maybe installing your Yusuf or whatever you might want to run. Going for the Liberated here. Installing a Paladin Poemo, yeah, just setting up and taking money from the Liberated. Yes, you have all the time in the world. Oh, this one is the one when there's enough advancement token on it, you can score it as a one-point agenda, public whatever. Okay, we skipped a turn here somehow. I think the camera camera had some technical issues. Not too much was happening here. You need to read in a public support. There's a public support. So you have four turns until it ticks out. And if you don't access and trash it, it's worth one agenda point. Quite cool for Jemison because you can forfeit it. Quite cool for Archer because you can use it as Archer fodder to rest the Archer. I'm wondering what the card is in the naked remote here. Armin didn't check it. So many glitching around here from the camera. A lot of glitching around. I think that is a G-Fress. That can be trashed for two virus counters if you're freedom, or you can just trash it the normal way. You want this to go down, I'm supposing, drawing three cards, gaining the click from Jeeves, and clicking for a credit. Oh, what do you do with the last click? I might want to install something, and installing another ice on the remote, yes. Okay, still sitting on 10 credits. One of those eyes is the Archer, one of those eyes is the Surveyor, because there is a second eyes on server 1. I'm supposing that the innermost eyes on server 1 is the Surveyor, and the Archer might be on R&D against the Stargate. Thrashing the last card in hand with the 0. That is an if at worst, that's a lot of card draw, drawing 5 cards here, gaining a credit with a single click, that is amazing efficiency, just amazing efficiency. So we have a MK Ultra in hand. A lot of money here, Poemo is ticking up, still a lot of credits left on the Liberated, so Armin is in a very good position here. Very, you're not forced to do anything. You might want to trash the public support. You don't need to. I wouldn't risk it. Just let it tick out. There is the Yusuf. Okay. Abusing all open servers here. So the chief server is a liability. Every successful run means one virus token. Running the Jeeves once, running the Jeeves twice. And the second time using the two virus tokens to trash the Jeeves, yes, that's the freedom value, the value of freedom. Now you want to maybe ice up archives. So one turn left here for Armin to trash the public support. Mandatory draw, installing an upgrade into the remote. Could be in the, what is the one? Oh, the one with the starship, the Jemison signature upgrade that lets you fast advance, possible. Okay, icing up R&D, double icing R&D, not icing archives, that is interesting. also don't have too many credits. I think 9 credits left here. That's not too much to rest eyes. And clicking for a credit here, yeah. Haven't seen too much economy here on the Wayland side. No too big to fails, no hedge fund yet. First steady car sticking out. Look at all those credits on Armin's side. Oh, he has so many credits. I would just try to get rid somehow of the MK Ultra in the hand, get it into the bin somehow, maybe with the zero or maybe hard install it. Just that you have all breakers available. Even breaking a Surveyor or a Archer sounds terrible with MK Ultra. And there is the turning wheel, that is good, that is discounted by the Paladin Poemo, that is another win condition here. You can every access on Centrals or on R&D or HQ that is not stealing or is not game winning will get a turning wheel token here. Running HQ. Okay, that's on Hortum. That's not too bad. You can install the Black Orchestra from the bin for free, break it for free, for two. Now free? Is it free install? So that's 6 credits total. You can just bounce, but I don't think you want to bounce here. Okay, breaking here, getting an access, getting an Yusuf counter. And supposedly a turning wheel counter here. That is an NGO. Bad. That's a good trash. You can trash it for zero with the Freedom Komalo ability if you want to, if you don't want to spend the credit, if you don't plan to run any server again here this turn. Would be best to use the Freedom ability. Thrash for zero. Getting a turning wheel token here. You might want to run again. Or you don't want to run again. Oh, going for the Bravado into server 1. No, Bravadoing the HQ. Bravado is interesting include for Freedom. That was unexpected. So the run is basically free with the Bravado on HQ, gaining a Yusuf counter token. Seeing another card here, it's another public support. Okay, now this time using the Yusuf, the Freedom ability and trash it with the Yusuf counters. This would absolutely go next turn into the remote, so that was a good catch here. Another turning wheel token. Oh, things are looking grim here for Wayland. The government takeover steal on R&D turn 1. Oh man. My credits are getting low here for Armin, but it was still very valuable. Oh no, perfect. So the zero hit did hit the MK Ultra. That was the perfect pick here for zero. Zero can be so good. Zero can be so good. So Wayland is scoring the public support here or adding it to the score area as an agenda worth 1 point. Mandatory draw. Still one bad pup here. Installing something into the remote, yeah, I think every agenda needs to go into the remote instantly. Install and advance, only 5 credits left here. And advance again. This is another hostile, okay. Oh no, this is a standoff. Ooh, that is also a cool include here. I'm guessing nobody wanted to do anything here. I think there is a very complicated text on standoff, but in the end it's just a blank 0 point agenda you want to forfeit with your ability. Second daily cast is ticking out. I have 2 turning wheel tokens here, only 4 credits available. Why not run R&D? Check 2 cards. So is he's running HQ, okay, paying one credit with the bad pup. That is on Afshar. This ice might want to go into an HQ next turn. Perfect ice for HQ. I think he forgot the turning wheel token here. There should be another turning wheel token. Ah, yeah. Mistakes happen. This is all casual and all fun, so no worries here. No worries. We all do mistakes. And it's a lot easier if you just saw the game as a neutral person from above, like the godlike eye from above, seeing everything when you're not playing yourself. Okay, he was putting the token on the turning wheel, not forgetting it. Running R&D here, I suppose. No rest. No rest. Single access. Oh, this is an ice. It looked like an Anansi, but I could be wrong. Anansi would be interesting. Interesting splash here. I think DL was sweating here. The single axis, it could be game very fast. So you are so much on the back foot. You're already on 2 points. You have one agenda to forfeit the 0 point standoff for the archer. I'm guessing the archer is on the remote, otherwise you might want it to rest it here for R&D, just forfeiting the standoff and paying for credits. This is the Afshar going HQ. And passing the turn, Paladin Poemo getting a token here. Ready to install, already 4 turning wheel tokens. You could go for a triple access on R&D. This is a hippo. Installing the hippo for free with the Paladin Poemo. Second click draw. Third click, running R&D. No res. No res. Oh, he's thinking about the res. If it's an archer, come on. Rest the archer, rest the archer. He has the money, but you need to stop those free accesses on R&D, especially with the turning wheel. I think it's 12 credits. It's 12 credits to break the archer with the MK Ultra. No, no rest. Single access here. This is another one of the spaceship upgrade. Yeah, that's very easy to trash. I think it's only one to trash. Again, another turning wheel token. Yes, DL is very, very honest here. And last click, running R&D again. No reses, single access. No, he's gonna access a lot of cards now. Okay, yeah, that's GG. Oh man, yeah, well, DL was such on the back foot with the early government takeover steal. I'm sorry. I was really curious what the deck can do. Yeah, well, but like I said, a single access can be game. Okay, that was 2 fun games, a little bit unexpected. So Armin is swapping DL here. I think DL is a little bit sad. That doesn't work out too well. Also the max, I really loved if we had seen the counter surveillance run on R&D here against the Tenin. But those are the things that happened. Yes, that archer was on R&D. I would have rested, but you never know. And I hope you all enjoyed and see you for the third round. Take care, have fun, and bye bye.